This video is going to be focusing on incorporating your in-text citations as well as creating your reference list. I will first be going over a sample search topic and selecting my sources, and then I'll show you how to incorporate your in-text citations and create your reference list. The first thing I want to do is navigate to CSUMB's library's website, and the second thing is that I want to open up my Mendeley account by navigating to mendeley.com. Then I'm going to go ahead and sign in using my email and password. Then I want to navigate to my library, and then I want to navigate to the left-hand side and create a folder or collection. So I'm going to go ahead and type in sample search and go ahead and press enter. So seeing that I have created my folder collection for today's video, I'm going to go ahead and navigate back to library website, and I'm going to go ahead and select advanced search. Then I'm going to go ahead and select articles, and for today's sample topic I would be looking at wildfires and the effects that they have on our ecosystem. So my sample topic has generated over 5,000 results. Then I'm going to navigate to my left hand side and select my filters to generate relevant sources. I'm going to go ahead and select peer-reviewed journals, articles, and I'm going to select a few subjects that are relevant to my topic. So I'm going to select wildfires and ecology, ecosystems, and wildfires. I'm also going to narrow the date range to the last 23 years. And it's narrowed down my search results to 3,000. So now to simplify the process for today's video, I'm just going to select the first two articles. Once I have opened the articles that I'm going to be incorporating into my research paper, I'm going to go ahead and import them into my Mendeley library. I'm going to go ahead and incorporate them into my sample research folder. So I've successfully included the first article. I'm going to go ahead and incorporate the second article. Go ahead and add the second article. So the second article didn't include my PDF, but that's okay. It has included my reference, so I'm just going to go ahead and move forward with that. Now that I have all my sources selected, I'm ready to write my paper and include my in-text citations. So the first thing I want to do is create a Word doc and start writing my paper. Once I need to incorporate a source and cite it in my paper, I'm going to go ahead and navigate to references and open up my Mendeley cite, and I'm going to make sure that it's selected to the reference style that I need for this specific paper. And to do so, I'm going to go into my citation settings and make sure that it's defaulted to the citation style that I need, which for this case is APA. And so once that's set, I'm going to go ahead and go back to references and then select the folder where I've included my sources. And for today, it's going to be sample research. So I'm going to go ahead and incorporate the first citation. I'm going to go ahead and select the first source, and I'm going to go ahead and select insert one citation, and it's embedded my citation. So in order to create a citation that has multiple sources embedded, I'll just select multiple sources and it should include both sources into that one citation. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and select both sources and insert two citations, and it's included both of my citations. If for some reason there is something wrong with my citation, I can just simply override the citation by clicking and making that change, or I could actually go over here. It says menu override, and I can change the citation. So now that I've included my in-text citations in my research paper and I have finished revising my research paper, I'm ready to insert my reference list, which is what we're going to be focusing on now. So in order to create my reference list, I would go to references, Mendeley cite, and make sure that my cursor is where I want my reference list to be. And then I'm going to navigate to my right hand side, and there's going to be three little dots. So I'm going to go ahead and select those, and then I'm going to go ahead and insert bibliography. And then it's going to ask me if I want to insert my bibliography where my cursor is. I'm just going to go ahead and select continue, and then it's generated my reference list. The only thing I have to do at this point is just modify by the formatting, so I can just go ahead and do that now. Now that I have included my in-text citations and my reference list, it's always good practice to double check your references and make sure that they're properly formatted. I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Hopefully you found it helpful when you're incorporating your in-text citations as well as creating your reference list.